Hello students, welcome to the class of Editorial Decode, and I am directly reporting from my bedroom. Now, as far as today's editorial is concerned, it's a very complicated type of editorial. It's an editorial that doesn't talk directly about the thing that it wants to talk on. It is trying to hit the things in a very indirect manner. Not directly hitting, it is indirectly trying to hit at certain points. So it is a kind of editorial that actually wants to criticize the present dispensation. When I'm saying present dispensation, the government of Narendra Modi, the way it has shown that it is going to lead the government, the way it has presented itself, the way it has highlighted itself, the way it has manifested itself, that it is going, what it is going to do. Now, as far as this editorial is concerned, it is not a direct editorial, it is a political editorial. This editorial will really help you in reading comprehension, because it is a complicated type of the way it has been written. It is not a usual writing. It's not a normal writing. So actually what you have to do is you have to read this editorial. After you have done with reading of the editorial, just try to analyze what the writer has tried to convey. And just try to absorb the matter, what the writer wants to tell. And then watch this video. So it is very, very important, before watching any video, you must read the editorial first. Now, name of the editorial is Raj Dharma and Buddhi Dharma, and the author is Peter Ronald D'Souza. It's a very well written editorial. I haven't come across such an editorial since months that has been written so lucidly, so indirectly hitting at the main point, not directly hitting at the main point. According to author, there are two things. One is Raj Dharma and the other is Buddhi Dharma. Now, what is Raj Dharma? Actually, it is a political editorial. He wants to convey ki sarkaron ko kaam kis tarah karna chahiye, how the government should work actually. And what is Raj Dharma? This Peter Ronald D'Souza, isne kya kiya? Jitna bhi iska meaning hai Raj Dharma ka, bahut sources se usko find kiya. And he has told us one meaning, that Raj Dharma is nothing but upholder and continuation and sustaining that thing. Now, what it means, upholder and sustaining something. Upholder and sustaining something. Why I'm repeating this again and again? I just want to convey that this upholder and continuation actually conveys the meaning that something should be very, very rigid. It is not like a normal thing. It is like continuation. It is like rigidness. Raj Dharma. The present dispensation, the Modi government, who wants to follow the things in a rigid manner. Now, is Raj Dharma the rigidity? Is Raj Dharma upholding and crumbling the diversity? क्या जितना भी डाइवर्स कल्चर है हमारा, क्या हम एक ही कल्चर को प्रमोट करके बाकी सारे कल्चर्स को खत्म करना चाहते हैं? Is that Rajdharma? This author, he has raised more number of questions than answering them. Now, why he has raised more number of questions? Actually, he just wants the readers to stimulate their minds. He just wants the readers to think the way he thinks. He wants the readers to develop an analytical thinking. That how the current dispensation actually wants to promote uni-religion and uni-culture. It has not been said in the editorial. It's my terminology, my vocabulary. Now, that is what is being conveyed in this editorial. That Raj Dharma is rigidity. Agar usko ek meaning se le, agar upholder and continuation ko hum lete hain. And this thing of the Raj Dharma The less pious thing in Rajdharma is the rigidity, and this is being followed by the current dispensation. Rajdharma agar multiple meaning le, dusra meaning le, it is a pious meaning. Dusra teen meaning usne bataye hain Rajdharma ke. This is also one aspect of the meaning, that you are being rigid, you just want only one culture to prevail, you want only one religion to prevail. And the second type of meaning, तीन सब मीनिंग बताए हैं ऑथर ने, पीटर रोनाल्ड डिसूजा जी ने, वो क्या कहते हैं, सी एज फार एज दिस राजधर्म इज कंसर्न, इट इज ऑल्सो अबाउट हैविंग द राइट राइटफुल ड्यूटीफुलनेस दैट यू आर डूइंग समथिंग फॉर द सोसाइटी एंड यू हैव द राइट टू बी द पार्ट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट, बी द पार्ट ऑफ द काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स. वो कहते हैं बहुत सारे साइकोफेंस, ही इज नॉट यूज द वर्ड साइकोफेंस, there are certain opportunistic people, there are certain opportunistic people who just joins the party to become this council minister or cabinet minister or something like that. Such people should not be given the berths in the cabinet. Now that is very good Rajdharma. And the second Rajdharma is that you are impartially conducting certain probes. You are impartially conducting certain investigations. Now this is being reflected by setting up special investigation team to get out all the money that has been stashed in the foreign banks. Money, tons of money stashed in the foreign banks. Now this is something that has been done good at the face of by the current dispensation, by the current government. ये अच्छा किया है. ये राजधर्मा का अगर दूसरा मीनिंग देखते हैं हम, तो ये बहुत अच्छा किया हुआ है. So then the author has talked about universal. It's about scientific temper, that is बुद्धि धर्मा. See, according to the author, जिस दिन से ये हमारा करंट डिस्पेंसेशन, करंट गवर्नमेंट आया है, उस दिन से जितना भी हमारा साइंटिफिक कम्युनिटी है, हमारे साइंटिफिक स्कॉलर्स हैं, उनका क्या हो गया है, दे हैव एक्चुअली मेल्ट डाउन देयर सॉलिड एंड करंट व्यूज, दे हैव मेल्ट डाउन देयर सब्सटेंटिव व्यूज. जो भी वो व्यूज ले प्रेजेंट करते थे अबाउट सुपरस्टिशन, अबाउट इंडियन कल्चर, अबाउट एसिमिलेशन ऑफ कल्चर, अबाउट क्लैशेस ऑफ कल्चर्स, दे हैव एक्चुअली टोन डाउन ऑल देयर व्यूज. क्यों वो डरते हैं करंट डिस्पेंसेशन से. एंड दिस ऑथर पीटर रोनाल्ड डिसूजा, ही इज एक्चुअली ट्राइंग टू एडवाइज द करंट डिस्पेंसेशन दैट दिस इनकम्पैटिबिलिटी, this incompatibility between Rajdharma and Buddhi Dharma should not be there. Actually, the good Rajdharma is that should allow the scholars, that should allow the scientific temper to develop in all the spheres, in the subject of anthropology, sociology, psychology. There should not be domination. There should not be hegemony. See, indirectly, this author has also tried to compare the prime minister of the current dispensation with the Taliban and with Gandhi. See, if you, actually the author wants that the things should be flexible. You should be flexible enough to bring about a change. There should be no rigidity. He is talking about modernization. He is talking about modern culture. He is talking about being flexible. He is talking about not being rigid. He is talking about not being strict. He is talking about not being obstinate. He is talking about not being like imposing something on other self. It is not about crumbling the disparity. It is not about butchering the disparity. It is not by forcefully accumulating other communities with one community. Now this was the entire decode of the editorial. So please subscribe to my channel. वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड टाइप ऑफ एडिटोरियल, समझाने का तरीका भी थोड़ा सा कॉम्प्लिकेटेड करना पड़ा मुझे. तीन चार डेफिनेशंस दी हैं राजधर्मा की, और एक डेफिनेशन के हिसाब से उसको देखा है कि रिजिडिटी वाला अगर देखते हैं, दैट्स नॉट राइट. अदर थिंग्स ऑफ राजधर्मा आर करेक्ट, But is the current dispensation doing exactly what the other meanings are? तो आपको थोड़ा सा एनालिसिस करना है, इसको अच्छी तरह से पढ़ लीजिए एंड प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू माय चैनल. यू माइट सी अ लिंक ऑन द टॉप ऑफ इट और ऑन द राइट और लेफ्ट ऑफ इट. प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू इट एंड इन केस यू आर इंटरेस्टेड इन बाइंग सिविल सर्विसेज वीडियो क्लासेस बाय मी, प्लीज कॉन्टेक्ट मी एट 84594000 और जस्ट गो एट माई वेबसाइट eiasmentors.com एंड प्लीज डू शेयर दिस वीडियो ऑन योर वेरियस सोशल नेटवर्क्स लाइक यूट्यूब, Facebook, Twitter, etc. So this was all for today. Bye. Take care.